Hello everyone, hope you all are doing well. You are watching this second part of chapter 1, Electric Charges and Fields. In the previous class, we introduced the static electricity, electric charge and methods of charging. Let's continue to know the methods of charging, which are friction, conduction and also let's know about another method of charging, which is induction. During a thunderstorm, the top of a storm cloud is positively charged while its bottom is negatively charged. This negative charge induces a positive charge at the surface of the ground. And the cloud's charge is produced by the motion of water droplets and ice crystals as they are pushed along by the wind. Now, let's make a note of the materials gaining different charge upon friction. Objects like glass rod, woolen cloth, dry hair, cat skin or flannel, a type of a fabric, gain positive charge, while materials like silk cloth, amber, rubber shoes, plastic objects, comb and ebonite rod gain negative charge upon friction. As we discussed in the last lecture, conduction is the process of transfer of charge by contact of two bodies. The charged body loses some of its charge, and this charge is equal to the charge gained by the uncharged body. The charge gained by the uncharged body is always lesser than initial charge present in the charged body. Positive charge flows from higher potential to lower potential, while negative charge flows from lower to higher potential. And most importantly, flow of charge depends upon the potential difference of both bodies. That is, if there is no potential difference between the bodies, then there will be no conduction. Induction is another method of charging. It is the method used to charge an object without actually touching the object to any other charged object. A glass rod is charged by rubbing it with silk. This positively charged glass rod is held near a metal sphere, but it does not touch it. The sphere is polarized as free electrons within the sphere are attracted towards the glass rod. When the sphere is grounded, electrons from the ground move on to the sphere. They are actually attracted by positive charges on the sphere. If the ground connection is broken without moving the glass rod, and then if the glass rod is removed, the negative charge present on the metal surface spreads all over because like charges repel each other, and hence sphere is left with net negative charge because of the excess of electrons and attains an equilibrium. Now you can say that this sphere is in equilibrium. There are a few important facts associated with induction. Inducing body neither gains nor loses charge. The nature of induced charge is always opposite to that of inducing charge, and induction takes place only in conducting and non-conducting bodies. Charge has certain specific properties. Let's know what are they. Charge is a scalar quantity and has additive property. Charge is transferable. It is always associated with mass. And importantly, charge is quantized. It is conserved. It is invariant. And accelerated charge radiates energy. And also, as we discussed in our last lecture, charge has property of attraction and repulsion. Let's now know about these properties one by one in detail. Charge is a scalar quantity, that is, it has only magnitude and no direction. It can be defined as excess or deficiency of electrons as compared to number of protons. Excess of electrons means that the body is negatively charged, and deficiency of electrons means that the body is positively charged. As we discussed in the last lecture, charge can be transferred from one object to another, and charges can be added. That is, if a system contains n charges, Q1, Q2, Q3 and so on till Qn, then the total charge of the system will be Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 and so on in Qn. For example, total charge of a system containing 5 charges, say plus 1, plus 2, minus 3, plus 4 and minus 5, when added, the system has charge of minus 1 with same unit. Note that one should use proper signs while adding the charge in the system. Charge cannot exist without mass, though mass can exist without charge. So, the presence of charge is a convincing proof of existence of mass. The mass of the body changes in charging. It is to be noted that when the body is given positive charge, its mass decreases, and when the body is given negative charge, its mass increases. Charge is quantized, means all free charges are integral multiple of a basic or elementary unit of charge E, which is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19 coulomb. The charge of a body Q is equal to Ne, where N is positive or negative integer, and the charge that an electron or proton carries is called as quantum of charge. Note that the SI unit of charge is coulomb, but it is a large unit. Therefore, charges are often given in millicoulombs, microcoulombs, nanocoulombs or picocoulombs. The coulomb is named after the French physicist Charles Coulomb, who developed the expression for the electric force between two charged particles. We shall discuss about this in the next lecture. By having the idea of quantization, one can calculate the amount of mass transferred from one object to another during charging. For example, if a piece of silk cloth is rubbed with a glass rod, a charge of minus 3 into 10 raised to minus 6 is developed on silk cloth. You can now find the amount of mass transferred to glass rod. How do you find it? We know that Q is equal to Ne. Therefore, number of electrons transferred will be N is equal to Q upon E. Now, substituting the values of Q, which is given as 3 into 10 raised to minus 6, upon the value of electronic charge, which is 1.6 into 10 raised to minus 19. Once we divide, we get the number of electrons, which will be equal to 1.875 into 10 raised to 13 here. We know that mass of one electron is equal to 9.1 into 10 raised to minus 31 kgs. Then mass of 1.875 into 10 raised to 13 electrons will be 1.875 into 10 raised to 13 multiplied by mass of one electron. So finally, we are going to get the mass of the number of electrons, which will be equal to 17.06 into 10 raised to minus 18 kg in this case. As we discussed in the last lecture, charge is conserved. That is, net electric charge is neither created nor destroyed, but it is transferable from one object to another. Therefore, net charge of a closed system never changes. Charge does not vary with the speed of the object. Therefore, charge is independent of its frame of reference. Another important property of the charge is that when it is accelerated, it radiates energy. If a charged body is at rest, it produces only electric field. If the charged body is moving with constant velocity, it produces electric and magnetic field, but no radiation. Whereas, if the velocity of the body is varying with time, it produces electric and magnetic field and radiates energy. Charged objects exhibit repulsion and attraction property. Note that true test of electrification is repulsion and not attraction, as attraction may also take place between a charged and an uncharged body, and also between two bodies with unlike charges. As we told earlier, charge is a scalar quantity and has magnitude but no direction, similar to another physical quantity, which is mass. But charge differs from mass in many cases. Like, charge is a derived physical quantity, whereas mass is a fundamental physical quantity. Charge is always conserved, but mass is not conserved. In fact, mass can be converted into energy using Einstein's E is equal to mc square. Quanta of charge is electronic charge, while that of mass is not yet clear. For a moving charged body, charge remains constant while mass increases. There is a term known as specific charge, which is used for the ratio of electric charge on a particle to its mass, that is Q by M. For a non-relativistic charged particle, that is for a charged particle whose velocity is very much less than speed of light, specific charge Q by M is constant. Whereas, for a relativistic charged particle, this specific charge Q by M decreases as its velocity increases. Okay then, that's all in this lecture. Let's meet in the next lecture with Coulomb's law and forces between multiple charges. Till then, take care of yourselves and your family and keep learning. Bye.